During the Buddha's time, Anathapindika was the foremost male benefactor of the Buddha. Anathapindika was very wealthy and was known for being generous. His actual name was Sudatta. However, everyone knew him by the nickname Anathapindika. Anatta means the poor, the unprotected, while Pindika means one who gives. When he was a young child, he had a friend who had a strange name, Cursed, and they used to make mud pies together. They both attended the same school. As the years went by, Anathapindika's friend, Cursed, lived up to his name. He was unable to make a living, and no one wanted to do business with him. Finally, he decided he could no longer make it on his own, and came to rely on the kindness of his old friend, Anathapindika. "My old friend, Cursed, it is very good to see you."
"Yes, my friend, I have come to beg for your help."
"What do you mean? What happened?"
"I have failed in my life. I cannot manage to make a living. I failed at everything I tried. I'm truly cursed."
"Say no more, my friend. You no longer have to worry nor even ask. Come live with me and work for me. I will support you, because this is what friends do."
"My friend, I have no words to express my gratitude. You will not regret this. I will not be a burden. This, I promise."
Anathapindika accepted Cursed as a member of his staff. Cursed was ashamed, but appreciative, and most importantly, determined not to be a burden to his friend. However, when Anathapindika introduced Cursed, the staff, owing to their strong beliefs in superstition, had strong reservations about Cursed coming to live and work at their master's house. Some of the servants voiced their concerns to Anathapindika.
"My lord, are you sure about this? His name is Cursed. Surely his presence will bring misfortune to your household."
"My good man, do not worry about that. What we get is based on our karma, our actions, not based on a name."
Cursed took his new job seriously. He knew that not everybody gets a second chance at life. He was determined not to squander his opportunity. He did not even think to complain, and was not choosy about his jobs. Instead, his mind was focused on Anathapindika's generosity, which filled Cursed's heart with appreciation and gratitude. Cursed did not think about how he used to be a merchant or anything else. He kept his mind on the present and accepted his lot in life. No job was too big or too small. All the jobs were merely an opportunity for Cursed to help Anathapindika and return the favor of Anathapindika's generosity. While visiting Anathapindika, many of his friends and acquaintances heard, "Stand up, Cursed. Sit down, Cursed. Have your dinner, Cursed." Hearing this, his friends spoke about their concerns.
"My friend, why would you hire someone with such an inauspicious and ruinous name? Having him in your household will lead to your ruin and misfortune. He is not your social equal. He's a failure and a wretch. Why help him?"
"That is not how the world works, my friends. A name is only a supposed convention. It does not measure a man's worth. A man is measured by his actions, not his name. It is not proper to judge a person
so superficially and superstitiously. In addition, this man is my childhood friend. When we were young, we made mud pies and played together. We went to the same school. What kind of person would I be if I forsook my friend in his time of need due to his misfortune? A true friend is there during prosperity and misfortune. I am not only doing this to help him or to make myself look good. I am doing this because this is the kind of friend and person I want to be.
What did you learn from this story? Let us know in the comments. We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads. And consider making a donation to support our Buddhist animation project.